This is called Impropera. It's a combination of two words, improper and app. it's impro, improvisation, and opera. So in other words, everything you see is that we're gonna sing or say, including this intro, as you can tell, is entirely improvised. Okay, so what you see today will never be seen again or heard again, which is a good thing. So in a way, it's a premiere for you, special one-off show for you. It's also a dernier for you and us. Okay, we'll never do the same thing again. We have two people playing instruments, four people singing. We'll do our best to enliven you for the next hour and a half. Enjoy the interval. We think that's an important part of the show. it's improvised. Now, if you haven't been to an improvised show before, let me just tell you that we do need some of your input in the form of suggestions. You don't have to get up on stage and do anything, don't worry about that, but you do have to shout out ideas, because we have none of our own. And then we'll use those ideas as a launch pad for our scenes and so on. So, to begin with, could I get you all to start shouting out something in this room? So, how about, make it easy to begin with, could you all shout out your name? Now, please don't shout out the words, your name. I'm doing this show for quite a long time. It is a very tedious joke. It may be funny to you, but it's not for us. Okay, so all shout out your names. I'm going to count you in because there's a musical element to the show. One, two, three.
Jenna!
Excellent, well done. All called Prada! Now, could you, again, the same thing, but could you all shout out a colour? One, two, three.
Red!
Exotic over there. Obviously, somebody works for Dulux. Shout out a mode of transport. One, two, three. Any bus, a late bus.
Sorry.
Right, don't worry. No, that's a way to get it heard. It's just to delay it. Boss. Good, a late bus. Any city in the world? Early. Premature, that's the other technique, you see. Getting before the count. Now, could you? This is a tricky one. Could you come up with? Could you shout out the name you'd like to have been called if you'd had the choice at the time, and indeed the ability to say it? So the name you'd like to have been given. You can't have Love Tower. That's mine. You can have anything else. So half to three. If you work straight, Love Tower. Right, after three, the name you'd like to have been called, nice and loud, and just to surprise the person you're with. One, two, three. Clone Rogers. Blast from the past. Clone Rogers. There are some of you here who won't even know what that is. You'll probably think it's a weather formation or something. But it's not. Anyway, Clone Rogers. Very good. So that's the sort of thing. We'll come and ask you for stuff. You shout it out, and then we do something, and you enjoy, and then you laugh sometimes as well. Bit louder than that, man. Get your money's worth, and then we'll do some more stuff, and that's how it works. Got the idea?
Yes.
Good. Everybody happy?
Yes.
Right. Let's start with something. George Frederick Handel. We do a bit of research. George Frederick Handel, of course, loved to write, but Baroque choruses. But he had to start somewhere. So what he did was he got a little piece of advice from people, and turned that into a Baroque chorus. So could I have a piece of advice that served you well in your life thus far?
Don't eat yellow snow.
Don't eat yellow snow. That's a good piece of advice, actually. Frank Zappa did that one as well, I believe. Don't eat yellow snow, but of course Frank Zappa nicked it from Handel, as we're about to prove.
Very tired.
Simultaneously translated into the Mongolian by my good self, as I am fluent in the language. So without further ado, all the way from Ulaanbaatar, please welcome Chow Na Ins Aukajin Aba Aindongra, but we call her Wendy.
Thank you. The billy goat is cooking. Indoors to use the oven.
More.
Okay.
good.
Hey Jude, I heard.
She loves me.
Be sure.
Yeah,
it's not a competition to see how many we can name in
Help.
Hey Jude is the first one.
Michelle.
We want Michelle. Okay, the boys want Michelle. Oh, they've done Hey Jude before. Actually, we asked because we've discovered that... everybody know the tune to this, by the way?
Yes. Yeah.
Can you just sing it real quick? So there's Michelle. Now, what we've discovered about a lot of Lennon McCartney songs is they weren't originally written by Lennon or McCartney. They were actually written a long time before. So Michelle was originally written by guess who?
Campbell.
Tchaikovsky was the first person to write it. Tchaikovsky wrote Michelle, etc. But he didn't finish it. It was taken up by another more contemporary composer who was?
Janáček.
Cracky. Okay, Janáček had a batch at it, but he didn't quite finish it. Somebody even more contemporary took it up. What's it? Philip what?
Lady Gaga.
Look at me. Think of Lady Gaga. No. I heard Philip Glass was the first thing I heard. So, yes. So we now like to present the true chronology of Michelle. Apparently by Lennon McCartney, but no, it was written by Tchaikovsky, Janáček, and Philip Glass. You won't even be able to see the joints. Pete Furniss, as the Ingle.
Yeah, hey. Wait.
Yeah, give me a chance. Thank you.
Ha ha ha!
We now turn our attention to David Pearl, who will be singing a little-known work from Schubert's work. Of course, we all know about the trout, but of course, Schubert wrote a lot of obscure stuff about other animals. Any ideas of what animal you'd like to hear?
Crocodile.
Zebra. Orangutan was sounded very clear, like you said. So, happy with orangutan?
Yeah, tell me about the orangutan. I'm not very good on the old natural history. Orangutan.
Well, it's an ape.
Long arms.
Orange.
Hairy.
Tree lover.
Arboreal, Borneo, mainly. The orangutan. Very often. It's one of Schubert's little known and great masterpieces. Now, in a perfect world, obviously, Impropera would travel the world with a chorus in tow, paid them lots of money, and occasionally sleep with someone. However, we can't afford that at the moment. It's rather impractical trying to get a lot of people to improvise at the same time. But you're here. And you've come to see a show about music, so clearly you're interested. So let me explain. In the second half, we will be performing a one-act opera, entirely improvised. The stories, the words, the music will be improvised as much as it's been already. And there's a little slot for a chorus in there somewhere. So with your indulgence, if you could be our chorus in the second half, that would be great. So we need to do a little bit of a practice just to get you up to speed with what we're going to do. You all know the tune, of course. Good. We're going to practice. So where would you chorus members like to set your chorus number in? Any location we like, preferably a place of work is a good one, like a hospital or a library or something like that. A maternity ward. That's very good. I can see a lot of good opportunities there. So obviously on a maternity ward. What a maternity ward. Is this, I'm trying to think, is the maternity ward, that's where they're giving birth?
It is.
Yes, I just want to know. Okay. So the maternity ward, obviously the women, there's a big role for you here. So you'll be singing, some of you will have had children, can you remember singing or shouting anything during birth?
Mainly.
And maybe a phrase would help. Get it out. I actually said that to my wife when she was giving birth. Maybe a phrase would help. Get it out. And get it out will be sung. Will be sung in to this tune. Get it out. Get it out. Get it out. So this is just the ladies.
Get it out. Get it out. Get it out.
To go for the shrieky thing, that's fine. So get it out, that's quite nice to punch it. Now, of course, there will be men at the bedside, as I was not that long ago. Yeah. And what's the sort of thing that a man says to a woman while she's shouting, get it out? Kick-off's in 10 minutes. My wife's on depression.
It's got real people's
voice. This is good, yes. Kick-off's in 10 minutes, and that'll be sung to this tune.
Kick-off's in 10 minutes. Kick-off's in 10 minutes. Kick-off's in 10 minutes.
Until somebody stands up and says, you have a baby boy. Okay, that's one of you. Or if you prefer to say, you have a baby girl, you can. Please don't say, you have a baby hermaphrodite. It might complicate the plot. Or indeed the prompt. German word meaning plot. So somebody, you'll meet at the interval, you'll have a drink of something, probably. During that time, get to meet your fellow theatre goers and just discuss and pick someone, or just leave it to chance and just hope it's not you. Okay, everybody clear? We'll practice again at the beginning of the second half, just so that you'll have other things to think about. Well done, thank you very much.
Sterling job, considering he's just out of rehab. Should I not accept that?
No, that's fine. I don't mind. I don't mind. I've tweeted it anyway.
Yeah, okay. we thought tonight, because it's going so well, that we could bond with you and it's a little further and actually help you as a performer loosen up even further.
Yeah.
We should sing really about, if you wouldn't mind, sing about what you're in rehab. Yeah, just find out, what addiction was he recovering from
cheese.
In rehab? To?
Cheese.
He was addicted.
To cheese, yes I was.
Not just one, but about five people said there is fellow sufferers, they know you from your silence. Cheese, it's now. Share it with the group.
Something of a loser, I was something of a slacker, sat at home just slicing stuff and putting it on a cracker. That's the way my life went for year after year. I was kind of lazy, I was kind of silly, just chomped on brie and crumbly carefully. I don't even touch Cheshire. What the hell? There's a knock on the door. It's another cheese vendor with a slab of rock floor. I don't want that stuff. I don't want your mozzarella. Get out of my house and don't come back to me, fella. So I feel fine. Given up my mature and extra mature cheddar. There's nothing I will touch, even if you say please. No, there's no reason for me to head to the fridge. I'm a failure since I quit. It's a privilege to say I just don't touch no more cheese. Style. Wee Willy Winky. Wee Willy Winky. Have we met? Wee Willy Winky. So that is Wagner has written Wee Willy Winky. Of course, we just better remind ourselves of Wee Willy Winky. If you need a reminding, madam. Wee Willy Winky runs through the town,
upstairs and downstairs in his nightgown. Knocking and tapping at the windows, knocking at the doors. Are the children?
She's a primary school teacher. Speak, woman. I don't know. It's tapping at the windows,
knocking at the doors.
Tapping on the lock. Is everybody in the class to say it's past me? Everybody happy with this discussion through? It's great. This, of course, was some of the dilemma that Wagner had. Trying to encompass various different versions of the nursery.
Just Googling it.
So, yes, it's, anyway, I think we have a version that we can do without further discussion. If you have any debates about this after we've done it, then please address all your complaints to Anthony, who will be to field all your complaints. So here we go with Wee Willy Winky, who runs through the town, upstairs and downstairs in his nightgown, crying through the windows, tapping at the lock. Are all the children fast asleep? It's past 8 o'clock. Thank you very much. Wee Willy Winky by Wagner.
Or the V Willy Winky.
minutes, during which time you can purchase alcohol, which we highly recommend. It's good for the show. You go away, come back having had a drink, the show's better. That's how it works. So enjoy the magic of beer and wine, and we'll see you in 15 minutes for our one act offer. Enjoy your interval. See you shortly. We're going to do a one-act opera, completely improvised from start to finish. The story will be improvised as well. Lord knows where it will take us. First thing we'd like from you is a few suggestions of perhaps composers you haven't heard yet that you'd like to be incorporated. There'll be probably some styles you will recognise. What's that?
Freddie Mercury.
Julian
Slade. Okay. We'll take that as the left field suggestion. Brahms.
Julian Slade.
Harrison
Virtuoso. but that's fine, yes. Well, I think we have enough.
Michael Bublé.
Okay,
well,
so.
What I've managed to write down here so far is Freddie Mercury, Brahms, John Cage, and Julian Slade. Now,
well-known bunch of
Pergolesi.
Chopin.
Chopin. That'll do. There will be something that sounds traditional in there as well. Okay, so that's it. We've got some composers. You may hear them somehow, in some way, shape, or form in the second half. If you don't hear them, please don't worry about it. It's not that important, actually. So don't let it ruin your evening, for God's sake. But we'll do our best. And that's good. So we have some composers. And what we need as well is a title. So, what we usually do for a title is we split it up into three sections. The first section, we'd like an occupation from this side of the room.
Drugs worker.
A what?
Drugs worker.
A drugs worker. Do you know, I'm going to say no.
Why?
I don't know. Drugs worker?
That's not very impromptu.
Well, we reserve the right to turn down anything. I don't know what it is. Somebody
taxi
works with drugs.
Astronaut.
Astronaut.
Casting director.
And a gynecologist. So astronaut it is. Astronaut. We'll have a drugs worker in there somewhere just to accommodate.
Do you know who one is though?
No, but you'll see how little we know about it during the show. So we have an astronaut, which is very good, from over here. Can we please have any city in the world?
Timbuktu.
Manchester.
Rochdale
or Manchester. I had Timbuktu. Let's take Timbuktu. And from over here, from anybody actually, because this is the trickiest suggestion. Could we have an adjective, which is a describing word?
Slippery.
Lovely.
Remarkable.
Lovely. Yes, we'll take lovely. Slippery. I don't know. That's probably going with the gynecologist.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
Good. Okay, so we have some composers. We have a title now, which is, if I can remember rightly, The Lovely Astronaut of Timbuktu. So that is the name of tonight's one act opera. It's a premiere, it's also a derniere. Here it comes, it's a derriere probably. Tonight's show is entitled The Lovely Astronaut of Timbuktu.
Thank you.
now.
Floating around, lots of knobs and buttons to push. Floating around.
Jasper. We seem to have a problem.
Is it a problem down there, or is it to do with my rocket?
It's to do with your rocket, of course.
I knew you shouldn't have designed it to look like a tenor sax. Soprano sax.
Here's the thing, Jasper.
What?
You don't have enough oxygen to get back to the Earth.
No. Not even if I breathe real slow and stop these songs.
There's only one thing we can do.
What's that?
It's code name Timbuktu. Open up the envelope, it'll tell you what to do.
Why he couldn't just tell me himself, I don't know. There's nothing on. You must crash land the rocket on the nearest planet. Oh my God, the nearest planet, where could that be? Let me look at the radar. If indeed a radar is necessary on a rocket. Oh, I see. Planet A5936. I've got to go there. Yes, I think that's what I'll do. Set the coordinates. The planet I just mentioned, whose name I can't remember.
Worker.
Earthy name, if you ask me. You're humanoid.
Humanoid.
And I can breathe.
I know that's just the chasing.
It's been 24 hours since we heard any news of Jasper's mission.
And you know who I blame? I blame you. If you hadn't fed his mind with all that tosh about being able to do what he wants, he'd be here with us in the mission, not there. Without my imagination, we would never be here, all the way from Reading to Timbuktu.
So, where would you rather be?
I'd rather be anywhere than standing next to you. Is you and that old car.
Well, since you mentioned the car, we've run out of milk. So,
milk the car. Oh, the car! The car! The car! It's a Reading way of saying cow. Don't do anything. Join our prayer.
Return.
Someone's at the door, Rosie.
I'll answer it.
It's a strange door. It opens outwards into our house. We can change that. I think we'll use the side door. Open the door. I've opened it. But outwards!
God!
Jasper, it's you, my son, words cannot express. Come and hug my chest. Final.
for me. Drive that cow.
Thank you.
a Sunday afternoon, usually 4 o'clock or 5 o'clock this Sunday. And we'll be there once a month. So if you look on the website, you'll be able to see where the next shows are. And thank you to Tet for inviting us here again. It's been great fun. And we hope to see you all again at some point. Thank you very much.